That's what the separation is. So you have to have tools, you have to have techniques, but the technician has to be sound. But here's what happens. We have a promise. We talked about a promise. But the promise is covered up by a lot of things we do in our life that aren't good. The procrastination, the lies we tell ourselves, failures, you cover it all up. Your promise gets hidden from the world. You rob the world of the gift of you. And when you rob the world of the gift of you, you rob yourself of receiving the gift in return, which is the freedom you want, the financial aspect of what you want, all the stuff that you feel, the impact, that feeling that feels amazing when somebody says, "Thank you, Susan, you changed my life." When you don't have that, you can't keep going. You can't pour from an empty cup. You can give all your effort out all you want, but if you don't get something back, it gets draining. The problem is you're giving all the efforts you want to give, not what you need to give at times. Talk about the person you need to be is going to pull more from you than you want to give. When you can accept that, things will change for you. Here's the big thing. You have to make what I call an identity shift to make shift happen. You know what that makes shift happen? I'm not going to say a bad word, but you get it. We all want, who wants some shift to happen in their life? Amazing stuff. Like, let me hear you. Let me hear you a little bit. Yeah. That's what I want. If you can't get yourself to that space right now, then you're doing yourself a disservice. I shouldn't be the one to have to guide you to say, no, I want this really great. You're going to understand what that means in a moment when I break down your income identity. Your identity ties to how much money you'll make in your life. Anybody know that? It's crazy. I'm going to show you how exactly. But that's what happens. If you can't boldly like, hell yeah, I want something great. If you can't say that, you're not going to be the person that does the thing to get that great thing. You'll stop yourself from it. So first steps, there's three steps we're going to go through on how to get that done. First is, get on your shift, baby. There's three ways you do this. Owning your shift is the first step to all this stuff. The first one is you have to own your shift. Literally, take ownership of the fact that something's got to change. You can't rely upon somebody else to get something else done for you to get that result. You have to write the emails. You got to make the phone calls. You got to do the video. You got to do it. And when you take ownership of that, now you can make some progress. Then you got to own your stuff. You have to now say, well, I'm in control too. I suck at this, 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 and this. Your problems, your deficiencies, your areas. If you can't own those, you don't go anywhere. Then own your shift. The work you actually have to do to own it to get things done. You got to learn what has to be done from your coaches or your strategies or the tools and then do that stuff. It's that simple, but that hard at the exact same time. In my life, I've had a lot of craziness. What you saw was my childhood and my cool stuff I've got done. But who knows that life can be really crazy in between? Hell yeah. It gets really crazy in between. For me, I became my bottleneck to greatness. I became the bottleneck. It's a possibility, I'm going to say a high possibility, you're your bottleneck. You're the worst person standing in your way for the success you want. For me, my bottleneck came in the identity I had. Our identities we have, who we are to this day, has a certain level of what it'll go to. When I reached my capabilities of the current identity I had at about 25 years old. I ran into a lot of walls that year. I came home from the NFL on an injury. I opened this business, the gym business you saw. Within 9 months, I was 2 weeks from bankruptcy. NFL money gone, didn't pay rent for 3 months. Some guy in a Harley rolls up, walks up, you Anthony Trucks, yeah, here. Served me with eviction papers from my landlord. At the same exact time, I'd been with my high school sweetheart, me and my wife, Christina, and we got to this point to where I left the NFL. I didn't know who I was now. I tore my shoulder. Who am I without football? Who's had something they lost that was who they were? You lost it. And now you're like, what do I do? It could have been a job that you knew was your job, the income you had, the relationship you were in. If you're anchored to that part of you and it's gone, it's like, who am I right now? 12 years of my life gone. I can't hit anybody without getting in trouble anymore. This is the closest I get to having that expression take place. And it was a hard journey for a lot of years. A lot of football players, 73% of football players go bankrupt within 3 years. I was right on path. I fixed it. I got a coach. Coach guided me out of the hole. I did more stuff in 2 weeks that was uncomfortable than I can even tell you over a lifetime. It was so hard because I had this ego. No, I'm not the guy that makes cold calls. I don't ask for help. I don't do that. That's not who I am. And he kept pushing me, and I felt uncomfortable, and I got something done. Within 3 months, we quadrupled our income. I bought a new car. I moved our gym to the one you see, all because I had someone shift me out of that place I was. I was the bottleneck. My marriage at home was falling apart. Like, it's one of those things where it sucks. I'm going to tell you the truth. I got to a point where high school sweetheart, through college, NFL, I'm the guy that's like, this is my wife, former NFL. I got my gym. 2 years after opening the gym, we're not connected. We go on a trip to Hawaii, and I find out she's having an affair. This is real. We're people. I'm not going to ask you to raise your hand on this, but this happens to people all the time. It broke me. I've now lost my gym. It's not doing well. Like, it's not in terms of lost it, but lost the sense of, like, confidence there. I've lost my marriage. I've lost my whole career identity. I don't know who I am. And when it happens, it's kind of like an anchor gets pulled up. Your ship is going somewhere. Anchor gets pulled up. A storm hits. You get blown out to sea. I drove off one night, sent a text to my friends and family, said, tell my children who their father was. And I get to, like, I was, to be honest, I went out looking for rat poison. It's 9 o'clock at night. No stores were open, thankfully. I parked my car somewhere next to a gas station, an hour from my house. I didn't know where to go. My friends and family called the police. They got GPS. They came and found me safe and sound. It was just too much all of a sudden. And we get to this point where we don't break out of this bubble and say there's something wrong. I got my mom who is also sick, and I'm like, I'm breaking her heart because I'm driving off. Like, we get to these deep lows, and I was in a deep, deep low. And I came back, my friend said to me, one of my close friends was odd. He says, Anthony, when I heard what was going on, he said, I went into the bathroom and I threw up. He says, I thought I lost a hero. And it was a really weird thing for me to hear because I didn't see myself that way. That's not who I identified as. And he said it was because I've seen you go through the stuff that you've gone through in life and what you've created for yourself. And I looked up to you more ways you even knew. And when I thought I lost you, like, it hurt. And then I had this realization of, well, wow, like, if I'm doing this on accident, what if I tried?